And we are back. Hey, now people are going to start filing in here and to watch this, hopefully. Hi, I'm Blockhead. It's a pleasure to see you. This is yet another installment of me making beats in quarantine, where I sit here. If you've watched these before, you may notice I have a new little setup. I actually have my keyboard hooked up. I don't know if that will come into play or not. Hopefully there will be no problems with connection, because last time was all fucked up. And the fucked up thing about last time is that beat came out really good. So you should go check that out on SoundCloud, Blockhead NYC, there as well. But welcome back. This is where I make beats out of scratch, aka samples, and I pretty much just using my Ableton, you know, just doing my best, having fun. And the challenge here is that I have an hour. I give myself an hour because this shit cuts off after an hour. So I like to, you know, try to get things done as quickly as possible. So I'm learning the lesson that if shit's slowing down a little bit, then I shall speed up the process myself. So I hope everyone's doing well. And I hope you are all staying indoors, because what the fuck? I just did a tweet about staying indoors, and someone wrote me a really angry, like, how dare you tell me to stay indoors message. And I blocked that person because they're fucking crazy. But also, like, shut the fuck up. All right, so let's enough of that. Let's look into some samples. I have no focus here. I'm just going to look for something that strikes me. So let's just start going through stuff and see what we come across. That's all right, but nah, I don't feel like that one. You can sample me saying shut the fuck up. Sample. Nah. Nah. That's crazy, but might have to come back to that bass line later. If you're just joining me, I'm currently just going through samples, trying to find something to start my beat with. That ain't it. That ain't it. This is the hardest part, is finding the beginning piece. Now, the thing about committing to a sample like that is, then I have to make that kind of beat. And, you know, I mean, come on. I don't want to do that. So far, a lot of stinkers, I gotta say. Here's the thing. Now, because this is kind of, you know, these doing this is exercises for me. This is just an exercise in making beats just quickly. So that sample is Russian, and they're singing something. I don't know what they're saying, but I want to take that vocal sample and pretend it's an instrument, and pretend. If anyone here speaks Russian, please feel free to tell me what this is. Bie, bie, the people asking me, I have a, here, I'll flip it around, let you guys see what I'm doing. I have all my samples in iTunes. They are organized by instrument. The stars represent what kind of sample, if they're a loop, if they're a vocal sample, drum sample, names, don't look at those. So yeah, and then I'm using Ableton. That's all I'm doing. Okay. Just a quick reminder. Fuck, I set up this little nail thing on my wall so I could put this phone here. All right, so let's this sample is interesting. I guess today's beat is gonna be weird. It's gonna be a weird one, so let's see if we can put it. Hold on. There's something really catchy about it though. Like I kind of like it. It's gonna get annoying, but I kind of like it, and I can definitely take the different bass parts and loop those. So I'm gonna do that. So I have an alternate. In fact, hold on. Let's do that real quick because I want to have a little, you know, be able to flex with this a little bit. So for instance. This will just be. Oops. And I want to get that high one. Boom, 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 boom. This one. So just have those two. So just to have those. It's good to have those. So we have the, let me get move over a little bit so I don't have that one part. And that way I can kind of use the vocals on their own. So it doesn't have to be. Whoops, oh, sorry about that. What the fuck? It's just not listening to me right now. Just to kind of give it some formation, just so I can, you know, I want to be able to just have it something to match up with, you know? Now, this beat is 84 BPM, so I need to something like that. That might be kind of cool. A little rolly drum. Turn it up a little bit. Yeah, yeah, yeah. weird. Is this? Let's try a different drum. Interesting. Something more simple, I guess. Or maybe I just got the timing off on this. No, should be alright. Weird. Use that Ableton, baby? I sure am. I sure am, friend. Let's see. I don't know what's going on. That's interesting. Maybe I'm. I might have to scrap the sample. I don't know what's wrong. I'm hearing it weirdly, you know? Let's see. It's weird. The speed of the sample does not match the BPM of what I'm doing, but I bet, hold on. This is my biggest fear, is that this would happen. So that will work a bit. I'm not gonna do that, don't worry. Alright. So that seems to be the problem then. Alright. I fucked it up a little bit. Let's get it right. We gotta pull this out a little bit. I have to change the speed of this entirely. So it should be going like this. Sample's all fucked up, the main one, and that means I gotta stretch it out and change the BPMs entirely. God, I'm fucking my hands this way. Alright, so. Go there. Kick this one up to 130 to make it sound right. I do put these beats on SoundCloud when they're finished. Sorry for that delay. I had a problem figuring out where the speed was. So this beat is going to be a lot different now. This beat is about to get is going to be a upbeat fast beat. Specific kind of break, we gotta go fast break. Let's see what we got. I transpose end time stretch to the person asking. I mean, like, it depends. When it comes to pitch stuff, I have to transpose because that's how you find the pitch to match. So yeah, I do a lot of transposing. I know I got a lot of these fucking fast breaks I never use. See if that makes sense. Just as a percussive element. Could be silly. Okay. Gives me some rhythm to it. Now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take out the low end from the vocal samples because I want the vocal sample just to be a vocal sample, and I'm going to just redo the bass lines and just have that be the bass line. So it's going to be like, let's see, how does this go again? This one goes last four. Okay. Whoops. I fucked that up, but I can just move it around. The problem with doing it with your hands. Alright. So, this is also a weird length of a loop. So it's gonna be kind of interesting. So I'm just gonna save that bass as it is. This will be a beat no one could ever rap to. I can tell you that immediately off the bat. That's a bass sound. All right. And once I get this bass sound, I'm going to fuck with the vocal sound a little bit and make it something a little different. All right. So the bass sound. Something to do with this vocal effect. Let's see. I need something that will kind of edit out some of the low ends. I think maybe the secret also will be to do a little fading of this sample, of the main sample, and taking out the beep boop beep boops from the main sample. Yeah. Emergency thing.
Perfect.
Go. See. All right, just bear with me. I'm just doing some editing, so it'll be like. The person asking me if I can filter the voice out, you can never fully filter something like that out. What you got to do is take the low end out of it because there's bass, and then I put an effect on it that kind of minimized that bass sound. The effect I put on it was called muted guitar. It's an old effect on Ableton. They don't have it anymore, I don't think. But normally it's kind of like you really, it's all about just filtering and finding the right. You have to be okay with it not being perfect because, listen, if I play this alone, it's not going to sound perfect at all. You can still hear that. So there we go. So still want to find a break that will work over this, something fast. Because I got a lot of fast breaks, man. Maybe. Might be overkill, but this is kind of beat where you kind of go for overkill, don't you, huh? Because why not? Why make something that I know no one's rapping on this, so it doesn't matter. So let's do it, Let's see. I still feel like I might have to edit something out of this, but. Yay, boy. All right. So let's see what we got. All right, so. Keep this drum for now, but I think I have a different thing in mind because I want something a little sharper, something a little that's not as slappy, if that makes sense. Crashy, I mean. It's really only when I'm looking for these fast drums. See how that goes. That'll be silly, but again, we're here for silly, right? Let's see what we got. I like the weirdness of that snare. Whatever, it doesn't sound like a snare really, but let's see. Nah, that don't work. All right, let's see. Okay. What if we went old school with it? What if we went fucking 1986 with this shit? That could be interesting. I could tell this is gonna be a beat that I'm gonna only put maybe like put one other layer on because I don't have enough time for this shit, but I don't know, I'm gonna get this shit right. Thank you. strum just for something, for a little break part. Because... That shit's funny. All right, so we got... All right, now we can move on to alternate samples. Now, here's the thing with this is that this... So I have, right now, you know, usually work in like 4-bar loops. This is a 6-bar loop. So that's going to be... It's weird. I gotta play around with it, but I feel like I need to cut something from it. And I think I know what I have to do. And it's going to be a little annoying, but bear with me. All right, I'm going to bring these guys back over on this track. Let's see. It's going to have to do some... Just play these at the same time. Alright. So, because it's a weird BPM, I got to. So, I'll kind of. This is going to be kind of annoying to show you guys, but let me. Let's see. Hold on. So, here's the waves, right? Now, what I need to do is, so we got from the top, these are the two waves. So I gotta cut that out and go, take it from there. So it'll kind of be like, let's see, hold on. Edit this, we'll edit this one up here, pull that out here and move it over, so. And then, see, this is going to be annoying, but gotta do it. Gotta do it. This is the hard part, guys. This is the part that you don't really want to do. So I'm moving this shit around. Let's see. And again, it's going to be kind of hard to find the right how it goes. But I need to move that up a little bit. That's it. All right. So I got that. So now, all right. So now I got to just make that its own track. All right. So that tedious process just made something very much easier for me. It's, you know, hopefully it will work. Let's make sure the volumes are about the right on these two things. So yeah. So I'm going to take this. Edit, export. Now hopefully this works, especially after with the effect on it. And I gotta adjust the bass slightly and it should be all right though. So now this will be a 4-bar loop and it won't be fucking weird. So I gotta adjust the bass. 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, so wait. Let's cross our fingers and hope this works. Got it. All right. It worked. Thank fucking God. All right. So. Got it. All right. Damn, that was really annoying. I'm annoyed that I had to do that here. But I'm glad I did because that was going to bother me, so. All Now we can go into sample matching, right? Aren't we happy for that? Yay. No, thank God. No one's really thanking God here. Don't worry. Let's see. Now, what goes over a weird ass sample? Like I can hear pianos going over this. Again, this is a silly beat. So silly samples. Comments are all very inspiring, guys. Maybe something a little inspirational right there? Some little inspirational gospel piano to go over this? The one thing I like about beats like this is that they're, you know, like I said earlier, there's no rules to like I could put whatever I want over this and it's fine. Because the main hook is a Russian person saying a language I don't understand. Patience for listening to the samples more than 2 seconds in when I'm on here is unbelievable. Trying to do too much on this because this is all stuff that I normally do, like, because this last note is weird. That's something, you know? Let's see what we got here. Got a little piano in there. Let's look for some guitar. See, now that's like some metal shit, but that could actually work with the bass line. And actually make this a slightly more menacing silly beat, which is always fun. Because you can never have enough menacing silly beats, right? what moment are they not good for? Sometimes what I like to do after I have a couple samples, because I'm not 100% sold on this piano thing. The pitch is a little flat at times, and sometimes it's good to place it up against different samples that already work, so you can kind of get an idea of how it will sound in, when kind of mixed with other elements. That part's right. All right, that guitar works. We good with that. What else we got here? You know, maybe some synth. What do we got? Just a question. The stream's running well, right? You can see everything, you can hear everything, it's not glitching. Let me know. I assume it is because there's actually people in the room, unlike last time. See if it works. See, like, it's funny, like, my natural inclination is just always to take things to a darker place. So even when I make a like a kind of like this sample, this initial sample is kind of a happy, silly sample, but like my brain just goes like, take it dark. It's weird. Wait. if that works. This was not the intention of this, but it is. That's where it went, huh? Works. All right, we're good. One more sample and I'm done. And I gotta do a quick sequence of it. So we got some synths. Yeah, this is very, yo, this is super Euro, whoever wrote Euro Knight Rider. It's very Euro. Well, the drums are, they're old school rap, but they're also German as fuck. Shit's mad German. But they got the, you know, that's when you gotta add the old, like. All right. So there we are. We got synth. A guitar. What else could this use? An instrument of wind. A flute. When in doubt, let's get some crazy fucking just stupid flute on this. I don't feel like I'm gonna skip horns today. Let's go through some flutes and see what we got. Let's get like a wild flute solo. See what happens. Cowbell. There's always cowbell. Wind chimes would be nice. Nerd? Is that what it's called, me a nerd? Dude, you're watching me make a beat. You're the biggest nerd on earth. Someone from Russia just checked in. Hey, Russian person, can you tell me what this is saying? Do you know? No, I didn't play. This dude said I played Mad Fan. Someone just called me a nerd, and I'm like, dude, I'm making a beat live. You're watching it. So who's nerdier? I don't know. Maybe I am. I don't know. So Russian guy, if you heard that and understood any of it, let me know. I need some fluty shit right here. It might be Polish. Is it Polish? Okay. It could be Polish or Czech. I don't know. It's written in Cyrillic, so I thought it was Russian. But you're right. What's up, Letitia? Let's do that. Let's see what this one's got ahead of in store for us. This stupid flute. No disrespect to the samples, man. This could be kind of boring, but we'll see. Oh, okay. All right. Then we're both nerds, guy. Thank you. He said he meant it as a compliment, but... People saying it's like Nirvana-esque. It is until you hear. So just people curious what I did to the flute, I added there's something called Sheen Machine on it, which is just kind of gives it a glow and a little reverb. And I put the auto pan on it because I just like doing that with flute sometimes. Just kind of want to put more effects on it though. I kind of want to put a guitar effect on it. Something more electric-y. Let's see. God damn it. Aesop just said to make something less Lord of the Rings, but hey, Aesop, you want to rap on this? Alright, I think this has all the parts I need. And I'm also got the intense left. So I'm going to do a super quick sequence like I always do. To remind you all what that looks like, I'll bring the camera over here to show you what I do for that. I just record every instrument at once. All right, just record everything at once, and then I arrange them. See? You guys don't. I hope you're reading what Aesop's saying. This is a big announcement. Aesop has actually liked a couple of these beats I've made while I'm doing this, so you never know. You never know. What could happen with any of these? Alright, so let's see. We got drums. We got many drums. Let me just sequence this real quick. Always the fun part. But I also gotta remember this drum doesn't come in that much. Maybe later. Okay, so. That it sounds like he says MacGroover in it, and it does sound like he says MacGroover in it. And that makes this beat even better than it ever was before. He noticed that. So I think I got the sequencing down. Thank you guys for watching. Shout out to Aesop. I don't know what he wrote, but I'm sure it was very complimentary and very sweet. And this will be up on SoundCloud probably within the hour. And then I will be putting it up, this whole thing up on YouTube later. I thought he thought about Gouda. Well, we're going to find out what it's about when someone translates it. So yeah, I'll put this on YouTube as soon as it loads up. Thank you guys again. I'll be back in 2 days because that's the plan. All right. Peace out. One love.